Okay, Assalamualaikum. So for this week, week 9, we continue to long run production cost. Okay, LRAC, long run average cost. So what is mean by long run average cost? Okay, it shows the minimum cost of producing any given output when all the inputs are variable. Okay, dia menunjukkan cost yang paling minimum, okay, yang boleh dihasilkan oleh output, okay, apabila semua input adalah variable. Okay, sebab we assume that in the long run production, all inputs are variable. Okay, long run is a period when firm plan how to minimize average cost. Okay, LRAC are derived by a series of short run average cost curve. Okay, so macam mana dapat LRAC ni? Dia adalah daripada terbitan daripada short run average cost. Okay. Ha, tengok sini. First stage dia menurun. Okay. Kemudian bila you tambah lagi, kita tambah. Maksudnya production, bila production makin bertambah, cost makin meningkat. Okay. Yeah, so in the long run, okay, in the long run, cost akan makin meningkat. Okay. Okay. Long run average cost curve is U-shape. Okay, bentuknya U-shape due to the law of return to scale. What is mean by law of return to scale? It means that as the firm expand its size or scale of production, its long run average cost will decrease and increase at later stage. Pada permulaannya, bila firm tu tambah lagi dia punya production, dia punya cost akan menurun. Okay, and kemudian dia akan meningkat lah. Okay, pada dalam kemenangan long run dia akan meningkat. So this stage we call as a economies of scale or increasing return to scale. Here is constant return to scale, and when AC is increasing we call as a diseconomies of scale. Okay, first we go to what is mean by economies of scale. Okay, it means advantage and benefits of a firm when it become larger and larger. Maksudnya makin firm tu berkembang, okay, atau bertambah dia punya production, firm tu akan dapat benefit. Okay, apa benefit dia? Because at that stage, it will reduce long run average cost. Pada masa ni, cost menurun. Bila tambah je production, cost menurun. Okay, so here we call economies of scale. Okay, so what are the factors that influencing economies of scale? First is labor economies. Okay, as a firm expands, it employs a larger number of workers. Therefore, specialization can increase the efficiency of labor and reduce the average cost. Normally, a big firm hire a large number of workers, kan? Okay, contohnya Proton, dia hire ramai pekerja. So, bila ramai pekerja, tengok Proton, dia ada buat specialization. Ada banyak department. Ada department pasang payah, ada department pasang cushion, ada department pasang apa rangka kereta semua tu. So, masing-masing pekerja ada dia punya task ataupun dia specialize. Okay, specialize dalam tugas dia lah. So, kalau dia dah specialize buat tu, hari-hari kerja dia pasang tayar je. So, cakap lah pekerja tu. Okay, so dapat mengurangkan kos kerusakan. Okay, kos lambat ke apa kan. Okay, so cepat dia kerja and mengurangkan kos. Okay, by doing specialization. Number two is marketing economies. A large firm can buy a raw materials in bulk and obtain it at a cheaper rate. A firm also can reduce the average cost of selling goods in large amounts. Normally, firm yang besar ni dia beli raw materials in bulk dalam kuantiti yang sangat banyak ataupun pukal. So, dia dapat harga lagi murah. So, bila dia jual, dia akan dapat untung yang tinggi lah and dapat reduce cost. Sebab bila beli banyak, dapat harga yang murah. Cost tu murah lah. Technical economies, okay, arise because of technological improvement in production. Large firm have more resources to use, more machine which are modern and sophisticated. The firm can produce at maximum capacity and fully utilizing machinery and reduce average cost. Okay, normally firm besar, the firm will use the advanced technology lah, okay, or modern technology lah to produce goods and services. Okay, so bila guna mesin yang canggih, firm boleh reduce cost kat situ and boleh produce dengan banyak sekali. And last is financial economies. A large firm can easily obtain loans from financial institutions as compared to smaller firms because large firm have sound financial standing. So, biasanya firm yang besar tak kuranglah masalah dari segi cost untuk buat loan lah sebab nak dapatkan loan mudah disebabkan oleh bank lagi percaya untuk firm yang besar sebab dia tengok statement bank, maybe company tu lagi meyakinkan lah untuk bayar balik loan tu lah. Okay. So this is the factors that influencing economies of scale. Okay. This economies of scale. Okay, this economies of scale happen when LRAC is increasing. Cost makin meningkat bila firm tu makin berkembang. Okay. Problem faced by a firm as it becomes larger and larger, makin firm tu berkembang, makin ada banyak masalah lah because it will increase long run average cost. So what are the factors? First is labor diseconomies. Specialization can lead to disinterest and boredom, thus reducing productivity. Once productivity falls, the AC will arise. Okay, sebab bila buat specialization, contohnya lah kilang porta tadi, pekerja tu kerja pak tayar sahaja. Okay, hari-hari pesan tayar, hari-hari kerja dia tu je. So lama-lama benda tu akan membuatkan pekerja tu mungkin boring kan. Bila boring, dia buat kerja sambil lewa. Ataupun maybe company perlu hantar pergi training balik, hantar pergi camp motivasi ke untuk improve dia punya productivity. So itu cost kepada firm. Okay, by okay, disebabkan oleh ni lah specialization. Technical difficulties. Each piece of machinery has an optimum capacity for work which is in optimum proportion to other factors. If this proportion is exceeded, then this economies of scale will set in. Okay, so setiap machine dia punya optimum capacity dia lah. So dalam keadaan machine pun akan rosak kan. So itu cost kepada firm lah, perlu baiki dia, perlu repair or find a new machine lah. Okay, to replace the other machines. Okay, scarcity of raw materials. As an industry expand, there is scarcity of raw material and as a result, the average cost starts rising. Okay, normally firm yang makin berkembang besar, they need a lot of raw materials. So lama-lama raw material mungkin habis. Okay, so as a result, the average cost akan meningkat lah. Contohnya, raw material dah habiskah yang dalam local. So maybe perlu import. So itu cost kepada firm. Sebab itu, AC dia meningkat lah. Okay, management problem. Due to difficulties of managing large firm, a large firm can face miscommunication, lack of cooperation, coordination and supervision of the different department of specialization. They will incur additional management cost. Kita tengok UiTM sendirilah. UiTM ni besar, ada banyak, ada berapa kampus kat dalam negara ni. Ada berkurang 35. So sebenarnya semuanya Shah Alam yang handle. Semuanya convo kat Shah Alam kan. Tapi sekarang perasan tak, dah lama dah ni, saya rasa dah lebih 5 tahun. Semua kampus bila dah dapat autonomi kampus, semuanya setiap kampus perlu buat konvo sendiri kan, semua cari income sendiri. Okey, sebab semuanya tak boleh dah relate dengan Shah Alam lagi sebab kita dah makin berkembang, sebab ada banyak masalah bila satu je kita punya HQ kita lah kan, Shah Alam tu. So bila sudah agak besar, ada banyak masalah lah, miscommunication lah kan, nak buat event kena dapatkan Shah Alam, lambat proses dia, sangat lambat. Okay, sebab tu sekarang kampus masing-masing je yang handle. Okay, sebab itu dengan management problem lah bila firm kita makin expand. Okay, itu contoh lah kalau UiTM sendiri lah, and juga cost kepada UiTM. Okay, so this is the concept of revenue. Okay, so ini sebenarnya revenue bila kita guna dalam chapter 7, next chapter lah, market structure, chapter 6 lah kan. Okay, tak apalah, kita pergi, kita tengok dulu. So what is, so apa dia revenue? Income earned by a firm which sell goods and services at a given market price. Okay, income yang firm dapat bila jual barang lah pada harga tertentu. Okay, what is mean by total revenue? Total revenue equal to total income ataupun P times Q lah, price times quantity. Contohnya kita jual nasi lemak harga dia RM1, okay, quantity dia 100. So you punya revenue is RM100 lah. Average revenue income earned from each unit of output, AR equal to TR over Q, and marginal revenue additional income from additional unit of output. Okay, bila ada tambahan quantity akan ada tambahan pada TR. So how many changes of revenue? Ini formula dia. Macam kita belajar MC. Bila output bertambah, cost pun bertambah. How many change of output? Macam mana perubahan dalam cost tu? Okay, sama juga dengan MR lah. So, next slide ni kita akan fokus pada chapter 6 nanti. So, yang ni kita akan terangkan kemudian. Okay, itu sahaja for this week.